The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 27th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Tat khetraṁ jascha jadrik jadvikāri jatasya jat sacha jo jat prabhavasta tat samāsena me sino. Yesterday we have discussed that two souls, the individual soul and the super soul, both of them are living within this body. This body is compared, in the Upanishad, the body is compared with a tree, and two birds are there. One bird is the individual soul, we, and the other bird is the super soul, Krishna. Krishna is so kind that he is always flying with the other bird, the living entity. We are trying to enjoy this material world, just like you have seen a bird sitting in this branch, going another branch, another tree. This is all seeking some pleasure. Similarly, we are also tathādehāntara prāpti. We are enjoying a standard of comfort in this life, and I am preparing another standard of living condition next life. So I shall fly over to another body, tathādehāntara prāpti. But Krishna is so kind, because we are all sons of Krishna. We are wandering in this material world as mad chap, just like a rich man's son has become mad. He leaves his home and loitering in the street and eating in the garbage. That is our position. We are the sons of the richest person. Vaisajyasya samagrasya. Bhagavan means we are the proprietor of all riches. So we are sons of such a rich man. Nitya nityanam chetanasya. But we have become mad. We want to enjoy just like there are many sons. Although the father is, in America we find many. Although father is very rich, millionaire, and he has become a hippie. Out of frustration, confusion, some other reason. So our condition like that, we are the sons of the richest person. Not only richest, the wisest. Vaisajyasya samagrasya bijasya, the most powerful, Krishna. The most powerful, the richest, the wisest, the most beautiful. Everything, supreme degree. We are sons of such a father, but we have become mad after this material enjoyment. This is our madness. So, as father is always kind to the son, similarly, the supreme father is so kind that we are flying from this tree to that tree, this body to that body. So Krishna is also flying. But he is not affected. That is explained in the Upanishad, that the one individual soul, bird, he is eating the forbidden fruit of the tree and enjoying or suffering the result. But the other bird, he is simply witnessing upadrashta anumanta, that is described, upadrashta. Upadrashta means witness. Upadrashta upa means you cannot avoid the vigilance of Krishna. You cannot do anything, conceal. Everything is known to Krishna. Therefore he is called upadrashta. And he knows that he will suffer. Therefore sometimes conscience beats. We sometimes inquire from our conscience, conscience says, no, don't do this. But he still is. That is our avidya, because we do not know. In ignorance, in spite of the Supreme Soul, Super Soul, is forbidding, don't do this. You still excel this. That is called Anumanta. We cannot do anything without the sanction of the Super Soul. But when we insist that I must do it, then it's all right, you do it. But we suffer your sequence. My word is, Super Soul order is, that you give up all this nonsense. Simply surrender unto me. I will give you all protection. But no. That is, he'll not do. Therefore, Krishna says, Tat khetraṁ jascha jādri. Jādri means as it is. We have got different khetraṁ. I have got this body, you have got another body. No two bodies will find equal in every respect. You'll find two bodies, you have got two hands, two legs, two eyes. These are all right. But your eyes are different from my eyes. Your arms are different from my arms. This is human society. Then there are other bodies. Animal society, bird society, bee society, and aquatic society, insect society. There are so many, 8,400,000 species, forms of life. They are all living entities. But why they have got different types of bodies? That is explained. Here, tat kshetraṁ jascha jādrisha. Why we have got different bodies? And jādrisha, how it is working, jādrisha. Tat kshetraṁ jascha jādrisha jad vikāri, how it has transformed in different forms, jad vikāri jatasya jat, and where from it has come to be so, such a jo-jat-jat-prabhava, how under certain influence we get this body. There are three kinds of influences, you must always know. Material influences. Just like the example is given, that there is fire and the sparks are dancing, but some of the parts fall down. From the fire, falls down on the ground. So, one spark falls on the water. One spark falls on the dry grass. And one spark falls on the wet grass. These are three conditions. So when we fall down from the spiritual world, as part and parcel we are in the spirit, our position in the spiritual world, but when we fall down within this material world, we fall down in such a way. Some is fallen down on the water, some is fallen down on the dry grass, some is fallen on the wet grass. So, dry grass means, although he has fallen, he has no material reserve. That is sattva. There are men who, just like devotees, the devotees are also wandering, moving in Bombay, but they have no such desire to enjoy Bombay. That desire is dried up. They are not walking in Bombay street for going to the cinema or to the restaurant or to the meat house or that or that, no. So don't consider they are on the same position like others. There are many persons loitering in the street, but they are different persons. They are not in touch with anything of Bombay material facilities. Similarly, there are persons who are via media, half this side, half that side. And there are persons who are fully in Bombay life. Or Bombay, any city life. We don't speak only Bombay. Suppose we are in London and we are wandering, traveling in many, many very nice cities, better than Bombay. What is Bombay? Bombay is nothing in comparison to New York, Chicago, Tokyo, very, very big cities. So, as we find there are different classes of men, although all of them are in Bombay or any city, similarly, all the living entities, they are not of the same quality. Some of them are in touch with the material modes of goodness, some of them are in touch with the material modes of passion, and some of them are in touch with the material modes of ignorance. So those who are in ignorance, they are just like fallen in the water. As the fire falls on the water, it extinguishes completely. And the dry grass, the spark of fire falls, taking advantage of the dry grass, the fire ignites, it becomes again fire. Similarly, those who are in the modes of goodness, they can easily awaken their Krishna consciousness. Because in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Jesam anto gatam papam. Why people are not coming to this temple? Because the difficulty is, some of them are in gross ignorance. Namam duskitinam murha prabhadante naradha. They cannot come. Those who are simply engaged in sinful activity, they cannot appreciate this Krishna consciousness. That is not possible. But it is a chance given to everyone. We are flattering. Please come here. Please, this is our business. On behalf of Krishna, as Krishna comes personally to teach Bhagavad Gita and ask everyone, Sarva Dharma Anparitnaja Mame Kanga Sarva Purusa. Our business is that. Therefore, Krishna very much appreciates. So, these people are doing on my behalf. I haven't got to go there. They are taking my business. What we are taking business? We are simply asking people, please surrender to Krishna. Yes. Therefore, you are very dear. Krishna says, Natatasmat manusyesu kaschit me priya cittama. Our business is how to become recognized by Krishna. We don't bother whether one is converted or not in Krishna consciousness. Our duty is to flatter. That's all. My dear sir, please come here, see Krishna's deity, offer namaskar, take prasadam and go. But people are not agreeing. Because why? And this business cannot be taken up by persons who are full of sinful activities. Therefore Krishna says, Jesam anto gatam papam. One who has completely finished his sinful activities. Jesam anto gatam papam. Jananam punyakarmanam. Who can become free from sinful activities? One who is engaged always in pious activities. If you are engaged in pious activities always, where is the chance of committing sinful activities? Therefore, the most pious activity is to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. If you are engaged always, Hare Krishna, Krishna, if your mind is always engaged in Krishna consciousness, then there is no accommodation for other things to come to your mind. This is the process of Krishna consciousness. As soon as we forget Krishna, Maya is there, immediately captured. So, therefore Krishna says, Sacha ja jat prabhavas. That prabhava means according to the modes of material nature. Karanam gunasangai asya satasat janma janishi. Why one is born in the family of demigod? Why one is born in the family of a hog? Why one is born in the family of a tree or a serpent? There are so many species of life. The only reason is karanam gunasanga asya. The living entity, as he associates with the guna, there are three gunas. Multiply 3 by 3, it becomes 9. And multiply 9 by 9, it becomes 81. Therefore, there are 84. 8,400,000. This is guna. Just like color penta. There are three colors only. Blue, red and yellow. But an artist can multiply the colors into many types of colors simply by mixing. Similarly, these three qualities, satogun, rajogun, tamogun, these are the main qualities. Now they are mixed together. Sometimes this portion is greater than the other portion. In this way, material nature is the greatest artist. You can see how she has manufactured so many bodies, nice bodies, 8,400,000. So this is due to our association with the particular quality. Now, so long you are in the material world, you have to associate with some kind of material qualities. But if you engage yourself in the devotional service of the Lord, then immediately you become transcendental to all these qualities. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Mancha vyaricharini bhakti yogena ja sevate sagunan samatitta etan brahma bhuyaya. Brahma bhuyaya. Immediately you are situated on the Brahma platform. How? Mancha vyaricharini bhakti yogena sevate. One who is fully engaged in devotional service. He is no more under this material qualities. Sagunan samatitta etan. Etan, bhavata. These three qualities. Sammat atitta. Samatit. Atitta means, transmigrating or transcend. Samatitta etan gunan brahma bhuyayaka. Because every living entity is by nature Brahma. But Brahma means spirit soul. Krishna is the supreme spirit soul and we are part and parcel of Krishna. Krishna is Parabrahma, we are Brahma. It is very easy to understand. You don't require to become Brahma, you are already Brahma. Simply, you have to be purified from non-Brahma, that is material quality. Then you become Brahma. Therefore, it is said, Brahma Bhuta, Prasannatma. Brahma Bhuta means, at the present moment, we are now Jiva Bhuta. Because we are in this material world, because we have got this material body, our present position is Jiva Bhuta. But when we surpass, when we transcend this material concept of life, the bodily concept of life, and that can be done very easily if you engage in the service of Krishna. Is it very difficult to be engaged in the service of the Lord? Not at all. Not at all. Why? The manvana bhava mad bhakta mad jaji mala namaskar. You are seeing Krishna here. And you can think of this Krishna always. There is no tax and there is no loss. Suppose if you come to the temple and you get the impression of Radha Krishna, so nice. And if you keep within your heart, but that can be kept when you love. Just like if you love somebody, you always keep within your heart the form of your lover. Similarly, if you develop love of Krishna, premanjana shrita, bhakti vilochanena, santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti. If you have actually developed love of Krishna, then you will be able to keep Krishna always within your heart. That Krishna wants, manvana, always think of. Manvana bhava mad bhakta madhyadi magnamaskuru. So, to become a devotee is not at all difficult. Without doing anything, if you simply follow this instruction of Krishna, manvana bhava mad bhakta. Simply think of Krishna. Here is Krishna. If you come in the temple, you get impression of Krishna. Krishna is not Virata. Here is Krishna Saka, Dibuj Muralida. Abhijananti manamurhamanasim tanuvasu. The rascals, they think that they are worshipping a man. Krishna was a historical man. No, that is abhijananti manamurha, they are rascals. Krishna comes to become visible to you, so that you can understand what is Krishna. So 5,000 years Krishna invented himself. He remained just like a human being. He took part in the battle of Kurukshetra. So he was dancing, he was playing in Vrindavan, so that you may be attracted. You can understand what is Krishna. Therefore Krishna came. But we are so unfortunate, although Krishna comes himself to show himself, so his activities, his power, his opulence, his beauty, his message, is still we miss Krishna. This is our misfortune. Why? No. Namana Viskitana Murha Prabhadanti Naradhama Maya Apurhita Jnana. Although Krishna is present, Krishna is manifesting himself, but Maya Apurhita Jnana, Maya is so strong that it is taking away our knowledge of Krishna. Therefore, if you want to get out of this practice of Maya, that is also given by Krishna. Mamimaja Prabhadanti Maya Medang Karanti. Anyone who surrenders unto me fully, he can get out of the clutches of Maya. Then he can be engaged fully in Krishna's service, then his life becomes successful. Thank you very much.